The day's finally arisen. Total Tank Simulator is out. It's May the 20th and the year of our toast 2020. So that means good news because we can finally play as any of the 6 nations that is possible. Now we've checked out Mother Russia. Hello there. I am Mother Russia. We've checked out the United States of America, both in the campaigns and even Germany. And then there's the United Kingdom. My God, they get a fight in Iran? But two of the nations that don't get too much love in World War II games is Vive la France and Poland. Poland can't even into space. But we're going to be checking out the French, and we're going to ask ourselves, why do French tanks always run away? I mean, they have one gear that they move forward in, and they have 7 gears that they go reverse in. Or so the joke says. So I think we'll choose an appropriate name. Act 1. Vive la France. Is this Charles de Gaulle? I don't speak frog, my man. So as the saying goes, it's not a saying. As history went, the Germans were like, hey, France, you got this big impressive barrier called the Maginot Line. We're gonna go around it. And then like Germany was basically like, Hey, are you mad, bro? And France was mad. So mad that they surrendered. But in order to get there, the Germans, in their Blitzkrieg strategies, had to go through the Benelux countries. Belgium, Netherlands, and Luxembourg, which that's this little guy here that no one ever really talks about. The death match in Liege. So the Germans are going to have infantry, air forces, and ground forces. But the French, at the beginning of World War II, had a lot of really strong tanks. At least relative to what everybody else had. Their doctrines, however, were inadequate to stop the Blitzkrieg. Uh-oh. The Luftwaffe. They got the Stukas. Oh, these Stukas are the dive bombers with the little sirens. Kill all the enemies to win the battle. All right. Well, what are we up against? We got the Luftwaffe with some Messerschmitt 109s and some Stuka dive bombers. So if we were to put up air power, they'd probably get shot down. We need to find an efficient way of combating that in order to defend La France. Yeah, I get it. They got quite a few planes. I'm well versed in the fact that their air force. What are they doing with Stugies? How do you can't have Stugs yet? Are those? Oh. Those are Hetzers, aren't they? Those are Hetzers. Those dirty little Czechs. Yeah, the SDKFCs. KFC's nuts. I'm sorry, I had to. Okay. So there's quite a bit of... Oh my God, they've got kamikazes and some light tanks. They've got quite a bit of checkery going on here. So what do we have available to us? We have the Renault FT-17s. We have some artillery. Ooh, the bunkers. I am going to put up some air force, and I'm going to have them attacking from the left. I'm a simple man. Quantity has a quality all its own. I think Joseph Stalin, after hearing me say that, wouldn't choose to put me in the gulag. Although nowadays, kids know the gulag is like from Call of Duty. And not history. It is very sad. Stalin's laughing. He got away with the greatest. All right, and some infantry, because you know what? Reasons. And some armored cars. My God, we have so much money. I'll put in a bunker for reasons. That looks like a bad spot. Look at that. Yeah, we have a giant hill in the way of our tank cannons, so we messed up, needless to say. But I don't care. We're starting the battle. Come on, France. The best defense is a strong offense. Look at it. The French tanks are already running away. I actually was joking earlier. Like, hey, let's find out why French tanks are running away. Is this for real? They literally just retreated. And they did it at excellent speeds here. I'm not entirely sure how the air battle is going. But if you look at the balance of power, it's clear to see that the French are a little bit ahead. Maybe we just baited them. We jebaited them into believing that we were retreating. But in all actuality, we were counterattacking. So with regards to how things are going, let's go ahead and take command of this guy. So the Renault FT-17 right here, it was known as the first modern tank. The reason being is because it was tracked, like tanks need to be considered a tank. Look at the little Germans hiding in the house. And then it had a turret that could rotate, boop, 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 360 degrees, although this one isn't really doing a good job at that. But don't worry, man. I looked it up on Wikipedia, so you know it's true. Hello there. Jerry's a German. Where are you? Hans und Fritz und Jerry. I guess I should say be saying, wee-wee. Oh man, a plane just shot me in the engine. All right, so I think now we've cleared the map of ground forces, and now it's only air power left up there. So we're gonna go ahead and do a little Kobe shot. Oh God, we missed. Oh, I guess this would be a way to increase our elevation, right? Whoa, 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 Tiger. Oh, I'm low health. I got wasted, dude. And no, not on the German schnapps or French wine, but the bombs of war. All right, so everybody's just crowding around in here, and they're getting absolutely ripped to pieces. But you see that little indication? We went over this in the past. That means, look at that, the propeller's not moving. There's kind of like some smoke coming out. That means, my friends, that the fuel is out. And no, not the Führer, the fuel. So, needless to say, a tank on the ground is pretty easy fodder for a battalion of French tanks who now all of a sudden decided to shoot at it. And the poor pilot is rolling around on the ground like a little caterpillar who's been attacked by 1,000 bees. I don't know why. Just felt like it was kind of poetic. All right, how are you doing here? You're not the Red Baron. Hi, there was a really cool German pilot who flew a Stuka, and like, he just destroyed so much stuff. He had a really cool quote, too. I forgot his name, though. Back in the days of me playing World War II games, like, all the time. Oh, you're looking like you're out of the the petrol, yeah? Oh. How's his landing? Oh, his guys bailed out right as his Stuka hit a tree. So basically, what you're going to see is all of these tanks converge on these poor little pilots who are seeking refuge in this village. But I like their little animations of them hopping fences and stuff. I'm still kind of getting accustomed to... Oh, look at that. Wait, do you have a Sturmgewehr? Oh, no, it's like an MP40. Dude, this is really cool. So the AI has them like, okay, guys, they're over here. I'm going to have to take command of this, aren't I? I think it's over here. Who is this guy? You're running backwards, soldier. Oh, my God, he's on top of my tank now. He's squatting like a Slav. Was it over here? Yeah, it is over here. Okay, good. Well, I got lost. We don't have GPS back in these days, you know. We had to like ask the local farmers, and if they spoke French and we spoke, you know, not French, it proved to be a little bit of an issue. So we've successfully beaten the first map of the French campaign, and surprisingly enough, the French tanks did go in full reverse. They lived up to the meme. So we've successfully fought that battle. And yeah, look at this. Now we have 350 research points. So before going on to this next battle, which is the Battle of Lille, I think it might be called, we need to go and see what we can't upgrade, right? Well, we can upgrade this light tank. Yeah, we want to get the Char D1. So we're going to save our 100. But let's go ahead and go to Wave. It's a Wave defense. Okay, so this is going to be a little bit different than what we've fought previously. And if you stay a little bit longer, what we're gonna be doing later in this video is we're gonna be showing off the absolute, like, super top secret weapons that these countries used, because we're gonna be playing the sandbox mode, which is just like pure battle simulator. This one's called Oblong Lake. Hold any key to skip. No, I need to see the Germans and what they have. I might be able to set up some artillery positions on the far side of that lake. They got that cool little cinematic. Okay, so at first we've got 3 Stukas flying around, and all their tanks are over there. I'm wondering if we just post up over here. It really depends what we have available to us in terms of artillery. We don't really have any anti-tank guns. And I don't even have any anti-aircraft guns yet. That's something we might want to research. But look at this. We get to show off our new tanks. All right, so if French tanks go in reverse right off the bat, and the Germans are over here and we want to bum rush them. Oh man, they got Panzer IIIs. They got medium tanks and rocket launchers. They got Panzerwerfers and tank destroyers. Oh man, I brought knives to a gunfight. Well, let's try to overwhelm them. So the upgraded light tank only costs $10 more than the light tank. So we'll put light tanks in the front to get shot and hopefully protect our really good ones. And like, oh my God. So the enemy's only spent $4,850. Cool. We got 3 fighters that should be able to shoot down theirs. And you know what? Just for good measure, I always feel like infantry can be pretty good too. And they're super cheap and you can have a lot of them. So luckily, oh my God. I was about to say the enemy doesn't have any artillery, but they really do. They've got the Nebelwerfer rocket launchers. Think of like German Katyushas. And they're absolutely just destroying me because in my esteemed battlefield prowess, and martial wisdom that I bunched all of my soldiers up together. I'm dumb. We get it. I'm dumb. But I can control the tank. Oh, hey, boys. Move out of the way, eh? We need to bum rush these boys. Wave 2. Okay, where's wave 2 coming from? I think the other side. I see them on the minimap. Gentlemen, you may fire when you see the whites in their eyes. Little Star Wars, little Revolutionary War quote. Hybridization. Charge through the forest. This isn't Warhammer 2 where you just absolutely hate fighting in the forest. Oh, God. But what I do hate is getting shot. Hey, stop it. Oh, wow. You're really accurate, aren't you? All right, if I hold repair, you can't shoot during self-repair. That's good. Repair kit is going to be ready in 27 seconds, so there's a cooldown for it as well. But once again, if we just want to see the gratuitous beauty that is this game, like, look at the colors, man. I really think they nailed the overall colors. Something's shooting at us from over here. I only see infantry, but what the... Is that a... It's a sniper.
It's a chopper.
Oh, man, and look at this. And there's destructibility of the buildings. So, like, look at this. It's getting... It gets destroyed, and now the infantry are either forced to retreat or, I don't know, fight and die. So let's see. This is the second wave, right? How many waves do they have? It's hard to see. Oh, there we go. I guess that kind of answers that question. There's at least 3 waves. Apparently, infantry just spawned in over here, and they were right around a bunch of my armored tanks. So this tank is just like running amok, running some over, hitting them with the main gun. Oh man, and the Germans have significant numbers. Look at the balance of power. It's not looking good. All right, I think I'm gonna have to take command, but actually do good this time. And look, I got a little infantryman just chilling on top of my tank. I guess we can transport him that way. This kind of reminds me of the video game Men of War Assault Squad 2. Oh, and Men of War Assault Squad, the first one. I really, really love that, and we actually had some really cool mods. If you think I should check that out, or you think you'd like to see it on the channel, let me know. And, oh, via Vespa. Oh, sons of biscuits. So Vespas are these, like, self-propelled artillery that are hiding back here. Guys, this is gonna be really, really rough. Okay, and all of my tanks, I brought knives to a gunfight. Hold on, let's pew, shoot this little Panzer II in the side. Is that a Panzer III? It is, or was. All right, how are we doing? Sons of biscuits! I don't even know what an ATR is. All I know is we're getting wrecked. Stop running in the water. Water is bad for tank engines. It's science. I wonder if the ATR is their little, like, rocket launcher, right? So I've got to drive a little serpentine. Okay, so there's a sniper just chilling. Let's see. Bad shot. I'm shelling that dude on the roof, or attempting to. You definitely got to, like, lead your shot if you're moving laterally relative to the target. Ha! There goes the roof. Can I run you over? Oh, I got critical. I got wasted by a sniper, but I think what really happened. Ooh, and this is actually good. We are doing better. We've slowly started to take command of the battlefield. We're overcoming the adversity on the battlefield. But look at this poor sniper. Oh my God. My shell just bounced off a tree. Yes! The victory is not in the Germans' hands. I don't have a very good French accent. Oh, well, we. All right, so what did they use? They used 80 units, and we used 169. I'm unlocking the Chardy 1 medium tank. And this is kind of cool. In Act 2, we're going to be able to unlock all this other tech. This is stuff that was kind of kept separately from us. And then there's the fire tank. Anti-tank artillery should be pretty good, though. Look at this. It's like a mini France's experience in World War II. We produced the Maginot Line, and then we're like, oh, don't worry about that forest. They'll never think to go there. Except we have a DeLorean that goes 88 miles per hour, and we can time travel. And so now we're like, oh, wait, we're going to occupy the forest. We're going to cut down the trees. We're going to use beavers. And the Germans will be like, oh, those are just beavers. It's a bunch of beavers. There's no French action happening. Oh, but there is. All right, we're out of money. So I forewent the idea for anti-aircraft guns. I actually thought these things were anti-aircraft guns. Okay, they are. They're shooting up. Now, look at all these explosions. I think that's us firing artillery too. I don't know what's happening. The Maginot Line is absolutely insane. It is destroying. Like, look at the air. Like, are air burst? Or are those planes exploding? I don't really know, man. I'm just the guy in command. So I'd have to say by the power meter above that we chose the right choice. And I think it's our anti-aircraft guns. They're firing these giant explosions. You have to remember that the Maginot Line is one of the French super weapons. And the super weapons is what we're going to show off a little bit later from some of the nations. Like, I'm very curious to see what the United Kingdom and Poland's are, because we're seeing a little bit of the French ones. And we've already seen USA, Russia, and Germany's from previous videos. So what's happening now? Because it looks like it's just explosions. Oh my god, I'm going to have to take command of an infantryman and go up against... Alright. Whoa! Okay. That's bad. I think the Nebelwerfer's recharged. I'm going to hide here behind the tank. But that's the beauty of this game, is one of the cool features is you get to go in to become an infantryman if you want. So it's like, hey, you want to get Tabs and Ravenfield combined? That's kind of what it's like. I'm going to try to be this guy. Okay, yes. Now I'm going to need to aim in. I can't see. Okay, well, we know that was a really bad shot. Oh, I destroyed a rifleman. But guess what, guys? There's no German rifleman up there. I shot my own guy. Okay, these really arc. I just can't see where they're coming from. These things are so bad. The trajectory on these things. I need to aim like up here. Oh, now they actually go. Oh, this isn't looking good. I think it's a little too far away for both of us. Time, 7 minutes and 5 seconds left. Yeah, so here's, they got some flak 88s. I think they just destroyed every infantryman I had. Wait, no, they didn't. Okay, I don't know if this is gonna work, but here we go. This is... Can I go inside of it as an infantryman? Oh my god, I can. This is incredible. Hey, Bob! I mean, Pierre? Jean Valjean, get out of there. What we gotta do is become this guy. Okay. Oh, okay, cool. Just more duff shots. Fire the cannon! Ooh, okay. We can win. I just have to be not inept, which is a challenge for me. All right, do we got it all? It was just behind that guy. I think this could be the one. It is. Pack 43 destroys SMG. That's one of our guys. Okay. Now, ouch. I think that... Come on, baby. Come on. Ooh. Whoa. I'm 2 for 2, baby. Now, there's a few more over here, but I don't have vision over them. So, we're just going to have to do speculative shots. Oh, I just took out a sniper. There's snipers in the woods. Will we be able to destroy this? Oh, wait. There's only one left now. According to the map, there's like one unit left. Oh, it's the Vespa. Dang it. I wish I had anything. Because the Maginot Line is awesome, but facing the wrong way. Hey, we got victory. I don't know how the Vespa died. It did, though. And that's just the French way of doing things. Woo! I like to see the sweet taste of victory. So now we just have this one. Look at that, man. We're doing pretty good. I feel like the French would definitely be like, dude, you are doing so good. We'll give you an extra ration of escargot, you know? Maybe some champagne. I think we definitely want an anti-air gun, and it's really cheap at 50 bucks. All right, so the enemy has some air power and a lot of tanks, so we're gonna need something that's especially good at dealing with tanks. So actually, you know what? I think the fighter bomber here, it almost looks like an Ilyushin 2 the Russians used. That thing is sweet looking. Look at those four machine guns on the back. Bombs under the wings. All right, what do we got here? Whoa, we gotta protect the VIPs. You will win the battle if at least one of your VIPs survives. But we have these three giant things known as the tortoise. And we've got some French industry here. We converted them. Like the USA were like, hey, we got car factories. We're gonna convert those to tanks. The French converted baguette factories. Ooh, Charlie 2? We got some big boys up in here. Okay, I got three VIPs, one of which is the factory. Oh my biscuits and gravy. We have quite a bit attacking, and we gotta protect it. Okay, so a lot of light armor is coming in the form of the Czech tanks. Oh, they got rocket artillery. That's gonna be dangerous. Now, here's their air force. They have 4 fighters and 3 bombers. So then my idea to counter that is we're gonna use 7 fighter bombers. So that's 2,100. So that's not even a quarter of my force. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we'll have Maverick there leading it. I don't know what the French word for Maverick is. Le petit déjeuner, omelette du fromage. I'm gonna do framage. All right, so artillery is super expensive. And wow, any tank artillery is super expensive too. I tell you, man, quantity has a quality all its own, but we just purchased them, so we gotta have them. All right, one anti-tank rifle here. One stupid expensive artillery piece back there. And then the rest, you guessed it. Vive la French tanks, boys. And we'll put them with the VAP here. You need to protect this dude with your lives. Oh, wow. Okay, we're almost out of money, so we'll get two snipers and the rest, infanterie. Not enough money? What do you mean? All right, VIP boy. Now, let's see how powerful you are. E, switch to the next weapon. You know what? I'm going to let the AI take it because... Oh, my God. Hold on. Pull back. We got to repair. Repair kit. Whoa, I didn't finish repairing. All right. Why do the French tanks go in reverse? Because the Germans crossed the road. Well, the border of the road. All right, pull back because that was a nasty barrage. Ow! Ow! You stupid planes! Oh, God. What is... Look at this. Once again, I brought a knife to a gunfight. Oh, hey, look at that. I didn't know my factory produced tanks. I should have researched that a little bit. How are my fighter bombers doing? I don't see them flying. One can only assume that they all died. Wow, we are absolutely getting overrun. And, oh man, the Stukas. Okay, so the Stukas took out both. Wow. Two of the VIPs and they're gonna take out the third. Are these pirate tanks? We have been defeated. All your VIPs are dead. Well, somebody commanded this army really badly and it's not my fault. It's my fault. Well, guys, I think it's only fair in true meme, French meme fashion that now that we've taken a defeat, we're going to surrender. We'll come back to it, but we're going to do some custom battles. So let's see what these transport planes do. Do they drop out paratroopers? Oh, they are. They're dropping paratroopers, but there's so many explosive rounds going in the air. I'm pretty sure. Look at this. Yes. Paratrooper invasion. Poland and France just dropping infantry everywhere, but it's right in the way of these giant tanks. But wow, look at this thing. These are incredible things. Like the French were like, hey man, I don't know about you, but we were in World War I, okay? And it was just trench warfare. You're gonna need to create the biggest, baddest, weirdest tanks you can come up with. Nice shot there. What's another French name? Pierre number two. And I guess the Polish were like, okay, dude, that sounds cool. We'll do that too. And by that, we mean we'll use the Char2Z, which is actually a French tank, because viva la Poland. All right, so it looks like Maginot was taken out. This guy's actually still alive. So, oh, snap. All right, so I'm shooting a heavy machine gun at a giant super tank, which doesn't seem to be super effective. What are you doing back here? We were wondering why... Oh, look at this. Okay. This is some super strange stuff, like... Was it really designed to have, like, teeth-looking stuff? Oh, okay. That's a big artillery piece. That's in the air. Let's kind of track it. Where's it going? Wait a minute. Oh, I was like, that's not a super artillery. But it's a cluster shot. That reminds me of Worms, man. You guys ever play the Worms series of video games? It's like they had the little cluster grenade, but Worms is, like, one of my favorite video games of all time. Like, one of my franchises. Like, so much of my childhood was spent... playing Worms 2 and Worms Armageddon with my brother and my cousins. Good times. Crazy, stupid, awesome weapons. Oh, guys, watch out! Ooh. Okay, so I think the poles here are actually... Oh, look at this. The commando paratroopers, look at that. You can even see the little what do you call them? Parachutes over their backs. And, dude, they're coming! Tons of machine gun. Oh. Oh, God. Well, Poland wins... World War II, ladies and gentlemen, Total Tank Simulator is out. Let me know if you'd like to see more, which nations you'd like to see, because there's more super weapons we can check out. We haven't even seen the United Kingdoms yet. So let me know if you'd like to see more. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.